All right, hey guys, this is Josiah. I just wanted to do another quick video here to show you basically how I scan for gaps in the morning. And I want to do this before the market gets open here. So it's about 8:05 Central Time right now. Market's going to open about 25 minutes here. And so what I've done, I trade using Thinkorswim, and Thinkorswim doesn't come with built-in scans that allow you to find gapping stocks in the pre-market before the market opens. They have some built-in scans that allow you to find gaps after the market opens, but those are really not very useful as far as what I've found. And so I was kind of forced to, I had a choice between either going with a premium scanner that's, somewhere between, $100, $200 a month, per month, to, subscribe to their data and pay for their service, their scanner. Or at some points in my trading, I've actually, been a member of a trading room or something like that, and so I was able to use their scanner. They would help develop the scan or the excuse me, the gap list in the morning, so that I wouldn't have to have my own scanner. But once I, started trading more on my own, I, needed to come up with a solution that would work for me. And so then I was kind of stuck with either the premium scanners or, what basically that was the option at the time. So what I ended up doing is developing some custom program ThinkScripts, basically for Thinkorswim, that allow you to find those gaps in the pre-market. And it's kind of funny. I think Thinkorswim really, they really make it hard to do this. They make it pretty non-intuitive, if that's a word. But I was able to find workarounds, and I was able to develop something that would work where I could, take advantage of the free market data that's in Thinkorswim and the free scanning capabilities in the platform, and so I could get rid of all those premium scanners that I had been using. So here we're in the scan tab, the stock hacker sub tab in Thinkorswim, and basically I've gone over here and loaded up. I have several different scans here available. I have my tier one gap ups and gap downs. I have a scan for, and these are in the pre-market. I have a scan for all pre-market gaps, and then down here I have some improved versions of the built-in scans that work after the open. So I have any gap, any significant gap. So this would be for a gap happening from the close of yesterday, and this would be a gap happening totally outside the range of yesterday. And then I have the tier one gap downs and ups for that work after the open. And so the all pre-market gaps, though, that finds only gaps that are where the stock price is moving outside the range of the prior day altogether. So it'll be either above the high of yesterday or below the low of yesterday. It'll be completely outside the range of yesterday's price movement. And the tier one gap up and gap down, that means that narrows it down even further and says I only want stocks that are moving in the opposite direction or gapping in the opposite direction of yesterday's price movement. So if it was a red candle yesterday, I'm gapping up, or if it's a green candle yesterday, I'm gapping down. So it's kind of an additional shock value, and so I call that a tier one. But anyway, so for the all pre-market gaps, basically I have some, basic criteria in here. The same thing that pretty much anybody can have. The I only want stocks that are above $4 or less than 200. I want stocks that already have some volume printed. Usually I keep that at 1,000 minimum. And I have the average true range. Basically, I'm wanting only stocks that move a significant amount during the day. So I have this set to 50 cents or greater. You don't want stocks that only move 20 cents a day. It's really hard to make any money in a stock like that. So and then I have the average volume. I want the average volume over the last X number of days to be greater than 500,000. That's just the criteria I use. Some people use over a million, you know, and so forth, but you can kind of set that how you want. Then this is kind of the line where the pre-market gap scanning happens. This is where it determines whether or not the current price is outside of the prior day's range altogether or not. And so, and then I usually set this to return at least 500 stocks. And you can see here, sometimes, you know, it's currently it's returning 124. That's what we have today. But sometimes this will be like, you know, 800 or something, or 500 or 400 or something. So if you only have this set on 50, then it's not going to be letting you see everything that's available out there. So you want to make sure that's high enough for, you know, if this says, you know, 50 of 800, you want to make sure it's above 800 so that it'll be returning every stock that's available out there. So from there, what I do is I grab anything that's above 1%, and I drag that individually over here onto my radar list. So these are all the stocks that are gapping down more than 1%. And if you notice here, the percent change column is all zeros right now. We're in the pre-market, and so this is not updated. But the mark percent change, this continues updating overnight. So this is useful for us to sort the stocks that are moving in the pre-market and find the ones that are the most interesting. Then we can scroll down here to the bottom and look at all the gap up stocks that are moving more than 1%, and we can drag those over onto the radar list. And there's some that I just kind of avoid altogether, you know, it just depends. But yeah, there's several, it looks like there's several interesting stocks this morning. So I would drag these over to my radar, and then I would switch over to my charts. And the chart sub-tab, this is my multiple time frame analysis daily. We got a 5 minute with no pre-market, then a 5 minute with pre-market, and then a 1 minute. And so I'll just go through these individually and look for situations that I think are interesting. Like this morning, Yahoo is kind of interesting because it's trading down under this base, breaking down under this base that has been created here. And so that's kind of an interesting setup, and you'll want to look at that further. And so any of these that I find interesting, I drag up into my focus list. And from there, I drag them over into a into my, I guess, my multiple time frame analysis. It's another setup here that I have where I can look at multiple time frame for several different stocks at the same time. So I'll have, you know, ROST here. I have the daily, the 5 minute, and the 1 minute all for the same stock. And then I'll have another column for the next stock and another column. And I only allow myself to look at four, to focus on four stocks during the open. And that kind of keeps me from being scatterbrained and not focusing on what's going on and missing trades. So, and then I'll drag these focus stocks over onto, you know, these charts here, and be ready for the market open. So that's kind of how I have my setup currently. You know, I go from the scanner, find these, drag all the interesting gaps, the 1% or greater gaps over into here, narrow them down by their chart, you know, any breakdowns and different setups that I like to see on the chart that I find interesting, I move up to the focus list. Might narrow that down further a little bit and then move that over into my real focus, my four stocks that I'll focus on for the morning open. I drag those into the multiple time frame here so I can keep an eye on like just a snapshot of you know, what the stock looks like on every time frame in that instant. And so it allows me to, you know, get an instant glance at you know, whether the stock is making an attractive setup in all those time frames. So that's how I have that set up. If you're interested in getting a hold of those custom scanners that will allow you to take advantage of the free market data in Thinkorswim, come on over here to biggermove.com. It's my website, and I've made a post here that will allow you to check out, and it kind of, you know, describes what you get, all those scanning setups that I showed you a moment ago, and it allows you to check out with either PayPal or BitGold. And so basically, I recognized that there would probably be a lot of people out there that would love to get rid of those $99 a month fees with the premium scanners, and would love to take advantage of the free scanning capabilities and market data in Thinkorswim. And so I wanted to get this out there for other gap traders like me that would, I thought would find this beneficial. So I hope that helps, guys. If you have any questions, send me an email, and thanks for watching.